Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to study about the economic impact of tourism. Tourism is an economic activity that has a significant impact on the economic conditions of the host country and the tourist home country. It creates ample income opportunities for the community in and around the destination. Basically, economic activity is related to money or generation of revenue. Concept of tourism impact. There are two concepts, that is positive impact and the negative impact. The positive impact includes rising income, employment, multiplier effect, higher GDP growth, reduction of balance of payment deficits, and poverty alleviations. And the negative impact includes displacement effect, demonstration effect, carrying capacity issue, and environmental issues. So here we are going to study about the positive and the negative impacts of the economic conditions. Tourism helps in the development of the public utilities such as potable drinking water, sewage system, transportation, public restroom, etc. It here says that economic condition, if the economic condition of the country or the area increases, the development will automatically occur in that place. The more will be the revenue generation, the more will be the money generation, the more will be the development will take place. The infrastructure will be updated and upgraded automatically. So first of all, we are going to study about negative impacts of the economic conditions. So there is a leakage, displacement effect, enclave tourism, infrastructure growth, increasing prices, economic dependency, seasonable characters of the job. First of all, leakage. What is leakage? Leakage occurs when tourist money are used to purchase needed goods and services from outside the area. The more imports that are necessary, the higher the leakage will be. The leakage is when we are going to buy or purchase something not from the host country but from the other countries. For example, if the tourism is occur in the India, but we are going to buy the products or things from the America or China, this is known as leakage. So the automatically the money will go to the other countries, which is referred as leakage. A study of tourism leakage in Thailand estimated that 70% of all the money spent by tourists ended up leaving, because in Thailand there is no production of goods or services are there. So the products or things which are there in the Thailand, they are either import from the foreign countries or are carried from the another country. So all the money which they earn from the tourism, they spend in buying the product and services from the other countries. This is how the leakage occur. There are two main types of leakage: import leakage, export leakage. In import leakage, it occurs when tourists demand standards of equipment, foods and other products that the host country cannot supply, especially in LEDCs. Foods, drinks must often be imported since local products are not up to the hotel standard, or country simply does not have a supplying industry. Import leakage occur when we demand something or we give the desires to the market that we want this or this from the company or the tourist destination, but it is not available in our it is not available in the host country, so the tourist places have to buy those products and services from the other country to fulfill that demand of the tourism. This is the import leakage. And another one is the export leakage, in which when another companies invest in our countries and take the revenue generated and profit created to their countries, this is also known as export leakage. For example, the McDonald's, KFC, Pizza Hut, all these companies have their outlets over in another countries, and when they earn a profit in from those companies or outlets, the whole sum of money goes to the main head office that will be in America, England, etc. displacement effect. Displacement effect refer to the physical dispossession of the people from their lands. Displacement effect generally refer to the movement of the people from one place to another due to some reason. It might be an educational purpose, it might be a some problem, or due to some kind of issues with the government, anything. So here is an example. Commonwealth Games in Delhi led the people of the village area to go from one place to another. So this is a displacement effect. The another is a enclave tourism. In enclave tourism, local businesses often see their chances to earn income from the tourists severely reduced by the creation of all-inclusive vacation packages. And this, when tourists remain for their entire stay at the same place or same hotel, which provide everything they needed, and there will be make all their expenditures, not much opportunity is left for the local people to earn the profit. And this enclave tourism, when in a particular area or region or hotel or resort or cruise ship, a tourist is going to stay for a long time, he or she is going to spend his or her money in that particular region only, that is in that hotel or in that cruise ship. So all the money which will be given or spent by the tourist is directly going to that hotel only, and this will reduce the chance of the local of that area to earn and to survive. This is the enclave tourism. On many ships, especially in Caribbean, guests are encouraged to spend most of their time and money on board, and opportunities to spend in some ports are closely managed. Next is infrastructure cost. In infrastructure cost, tourism development can cost the local government and local taxpayers a great deal of money. Developers may want the government to improve the airports, roads and other infrastructures, and possibly to provide the tax breaks and other financial advantages, which are costly activities for the government. When there is an increase in the economic or decrease in the economic conditions, the infrastructure has to be evaluated that time. The cost which is needed to maintain the infrastructure is might be higher than the cost we have earned. So it is one of the negative impact of the tourism, that infrastructure have to be maintained for the long time, and there is a demand of the infrastructure cost, that it will increase the infrastructure cost. The next one is increase in prices. When there will be the demand, higher will be the demand, higher will be the cost. On the basis of the services and goods from the tourists will often causes price hikes, that is negatively affects local people and residents whose income does not increase proportionally. Tourism development and the related rise in real estate demand may dramatically increase building cost and land value. This make it more difficult for the local people to meet their basic daily needs. For example, if we are going to the metropolitan cities, or we are going to southern Pacific region, the prices of the thing there are very high. The common or daily usable things are very high. So for the locals also, it will be difficult to survive over there, because they are not even able to buy those daily usable things. So it will increase the price, and this is the negative impact for both the tourists as well as the local people. The next one is economic dependency on the local community on tourism. Diversification in any economy is a sign of health. However, if a country or a region become dependent for its economic survival upon one industry, it can put major stress on this industry as well as people involved to perform well. In many countries, especially developing countries with a little ability to explore other resources, have embraced tourism as a way to boost the economy. As if we are going to depend totally on the tourism, we are going to depend on the local community, because tourism is a wholesome process of the people involvement. The local people are the main key sources which is needed in that tourism process. But if somehow the tourism is not going to be that good in that area, the whole industry is going to face the problem. The local community have to be in loss, and it is very difficult to survive for them. So total dependency on that area or on that people is not a good thing, which is a negative thing. They might lose their job, they will might not able to earn more because of the tourism growth. So it is depend upon the time and the tourist flow. The next one is seasonal characteristics of the job. This is a seasonal characteristic of job, means according to the season jobs changes. When there is a peak season in the Jammu and Kashmir, the hotel may get hire the staff, but when there is a lean season, they say no to the staff, and might even though they shut their hotels and restaurants. So this is a kind of negative impact of the economics, because according to the market demand they hire, and when there is no demand they deploy them. No guarantee of employment from one season to the next season. Difficulties in getting training, employment, medical benefits, etc. So this is all for the negative impacts, and in the next session we are going to study about the positive impacts.